فلتحيا غزة، فلتحيا غزة، فلتحيا غزة، لبيك يا أقصى، لبيك يا أقصى، لبيك يا أقصى، بالروح بالدم نفديك يا أقصى.
What about like 56 Islamic countries? You have a vapor, you have oil, you have gold, you have money.
Yeah, but all dogs, all dogs. They only care about money and all allies.
ہم اس ظالم کو برداشت نہیں کر سکتے دنیا کا سب سے بڑا دہشت گرد
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم السلام علیکم میں ہوں سبیق اعظمی ناظرین میرے پیچھے آپ کو فلسطین کی حمایت میں میلبرن میں ایک ریلی نظر آ رہی ہے اس ریلی میں بچے بوڑھے عورتیں حاملہ عورتیں تک شامل ہیں اور اس میں ہر رنگ مذہب کے لوگ شامل ہیں ان میں عیسائی بھی ہیں یہودی بھی ہیں ان میں مسلمان بھی ہیں ان میں ہر وہ شخص جس کا کوئی کردار ہے جس کے اندر کوئی تھوڑی سی انسانیت باقی ہے وہ یہاں موجود ہے اور ان سب کے لبوں پر جو آواز ہے وہ ہے فری پیلسٹائن اس ظلم کو اس بربریت کو بند کیا جائے یہ لوگ ظالم کے خلاف اکٹھے ہوئے ہیں جو ہر دور میں کسی نہ کسی شکل میں موجود تھا ان کے سوالات ہیں ان 55 یا 56 اسلامی ممالک کی لیڈرشپ سے جہاں پر یہاں طیب رجب اردگان عمران خان یا پیوٹن کی ایون تعریف ہو رہی ہے کہ وہاں پر ان مسلمان ممالک کے عرب لیڈران کو سخت تنقید کا نشانہ بھی بنایا جا رہا ہے جو کہ ظلم اور بربریت پر بول نہیں رہے پاکستان کی طرف سے یہاں الحمدللہ مجھے نمائندگی مل گئی اور بڑی خوشی کی بات ہے کہ بہت سارے جھنڈوں میں پاکستان کا جھنڈا نظر نہیں آیا لیکن پاکستانی لوگ موجود ہیں اور یہاں پر اپنی موجودگی سے یہ اپنا جو ایک ان کا تاثر ہے کہ ہم فلسطین کے ساتھ ہیں سوشل میڈیا کے علاوہ بھی وہ یہاں گراؤنڈ پر موجود ہے آج عید کا دوسرا دن ہے لیکن لوگ یہاں پر خوش ہیں اور لوگ یہاں پر خوش اس وجہ سے ہیں کہ یہاں پر وہ اس بڑے پروٹیسٹ میں ظلم کے خلاف آواز بلند کرنے والوں میں سے ہیں یہ آپ کو پتہ ہے مسئلہ جب برطانیہ نے وہاں سے وہ علاقہ چھوڑا تھا تو اس پر میں مزید جو تفصیلات ہیں وہ انشاءاللہ آپ کے سامنے رکھوں گا کہ کیسے وہاں فلسطین سے انہوں نے اسرائیل بنایا لیکن آئیں کچھ لوگوں سے بات کرتے ہیں اور ان لوگوں کا جو پروٹیسٹ ہے وہ آپ تک پہنچاتے ہیں انشاءاللہ اگلے جو اس میں ڈیٹیل اور مزید تفصیلات ہوں گی وہ میں آپ کو ساتھ ساتھ اپڈیٹ کرتا رہوں گا آج میرے ساتھ ایک چھوٹی سی بریک کے بعد کچھ لوگ مختلف نیشنلٹیز کے قومیت کے موجود ہیں آئیں ان سے بات کرتے ہیں
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم لا ترکنوا الی الذین ظلموا ہم کسی بھی صورت کسی بھی ظالم کو کبھی برداشت نہیں کر سکتے اور دنیا کا سب سے بڑا ظالم اسرائیل ہے 1948 سے اس نے فلسطینیوں کی مقدس سرزمین پر قبضہ کر رکھا ہے اور جمعۃ الوداع فلسطینیوں کے حقوق کی آواز بلند کرنے کا دن ہے اور اس دن سے آج 9واں دن ہے کہ فلسطین کے اندر بومبنگ ہو رہی ہے F-15 F-16 سے حملے ہو رہے ہیں بچے قتل کیے جا رہے ہیں عورتیں قتل کی جا رہی ہیں گھر تباہ کیے جا رہے ہیں ہم اس ظالم کو برداشت نہیں کر سکتے دنیا کا سب سے بڑا دہشت گرد اسرائیل ہے اور دنیا کے سب سے بڑے مظلوم فلسطینین ہے ساری دنیا متحد ہے ظلم کا خاتمہ ہوگا اور ہم اس وقت تک اپنی آواز بلند کریں گے جب تک کہ ظلم اس دنیا سے مٹ نہ جائے مٹا دو ظلم
Why we're here today?
To stand up for Palestine and the injustices that are happening in Palestine.
Brother, why this is 73 years this is happening? Why the world is so quiet?
Inshallah, only God knows. You know, it's wrong. What's happening? It's wrong. Yeah.
So we're standing here for the protests and we're standing with the Palestinian people.
Of course, all the way.
Where are you from, brother?
New Zealand originally.
New Zealand, mashallah. Aaj idhar Palestine walon ke liye duniya ikatthi hui hai, mazloom Palestiniyon ke liye pura Australia. Aap log yahan par, aap to musalman bhi nahi hai, log to samajhte hain Palestini musalman hai shayad isliye log. To ye aap kyun aaye hain yahan?
Assi Sikh hon de nate aaye hain ji itthe. Sikh hon de nate sada farz banda ji je kise mazloom naal دنیا دے کتے بھی تکا ہوندا تا اودے نال کھڑنا جی تے ہا دا نعرہ مارنا
دیکھا ہے جب بھی کہیں دنیا میں چاہے کشمیر ہو چاہے کہیں بھی ہو سکھ برادری سب سے پہلے آتی ہے آخر ایسا کیوں ہے آپ لوگ مظلوم کے لیے کیوں اتنی جلدی مدد کے لیے آتے ہیں
ویکھو تے دو کارن جی ایک تا سانو گرو صاحب والو حکم ہے مظلوم نال کھڑنا ایک اسی بھی بہت اوکھے سمے دے وچوں نکل رہے ہیں جی تے اسی اس پیڑ نو محسوس بھی کردے ہاں کہ جدوں حکومتاں والوں किसी मनोरिटी के नाल धक्का हों किसी ताकतवर वालों किसी मजलूम नाल धक्का हों तो असं उन्होंने बहुत चंगी तरह महसूस कर सकते हैं जी।
मुझे यकीन है पाकिस्तान में जो लोग देख रहे होंगे वो सब आपका शुक्रिया अदा करेंगे कि आप लोग हमेशा जब भी कोई मजलूम दुनिया में जुल्म हो सिख सबसे पहले उनके लिए खड़े होते हैं। मेरी तरफ से पूरा पाकिस्तान की तरफ से आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।
कोई चक्कर नहीं जी, धन्यवाद बहुत बहुत। बाकी साडा फर्ज है जी, तुहानू शुक्रगुजार करने की लोड़ नहीं जी।
इजिप्शियन
इजिप्शियन, सो वी हैव इजिप्शियन हियर एज़ वेल। सर आर यू मुस्लिम इफ यू डोंट माइंड मी
आई एम मुस्लिम।
सो दिस इनजस्टिस हैपनिंग टू मुस्लिम्स, हाउ डू यू फील दैट?
इट्स वेरी डिस्टर्बिंग।
इट ब्रेक्स योर हार्ट?
Always.
It's very emotional seeing little children, especially like 1 year, 3 years old, dying like
this. Yeah, in Yemen, Palestine, Afghanistan, everywhere in the Middle East, everywhere. It's pretty scary.
Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Brother, where are you from?
I'm from Bosnia.
Why the world is not taking any notice of our tears, our injustice?
It's gonna come. You have to have sabr.
Michael, my friends, he's originally from Australia, but he's got a background from India as well, from Gujarat. Michael, why are you here?
I'm here to support the wonderful Palestinian people who are struggling at the front lines against the global struggle against racism and inequality.
Ki main badi der se meri nigahein dhoond rahi thi, mere Pakistani kahan hain? Mujhe mil gaye Faisalabad se.
Lahore se.
Lahore se, sorry, Lahore se. Aap yahan par kya kar rahe hain aaj?
Ji, main aaj is protest mein shamil hone aaya hoon. Main Palestine के काज को सपोर्ट करने आया हूं और इसराइल की जो टेररिज्म है उसको अपोज करने आया हूं।
पाकिस्तान में आपने देखा कि लोग जिस तरह मोहब्बत से पिछले चार दिनों से ईद के मौके पर लोग सब कुछ भूल कर सिर्फ और सिर्फ गजा और फलस्तीन के लिए रो रहे हैं इस वक्त। बड़ा दुख का वो था। आप यहाँ पर देख रहे हैं हर कम्यूनिटी के लोग आए हुए हैं, कैसा महसूस कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर?
They really, we are really sad what happened in last few days and what is happening, and really Pakistan community is really really sad in Australia, and we really our lot of Pakistani they have joined this protest and we want to support our Palestinian brothers.
Inshallah.
लोग मेरा ख्याल है अपना एहतजाज रिकॉर्ड कर रहे हैं। मुसलमान लोग मेलबर्न के और बाकी भी अतराफ़ से लोग आए हुए, तो ये काम हो रहा है। एक मतलब बहुत बड़ा जुल्म हो रहा है दुनिया में, बहुत बड़ा जुल्म।
نحن جئنا هنا حتى نتضامن مع اخواننا في فلسطين, جئنا لحماية الاقصى, جئنا لحماية الاسلام, جئنا لمحبة بعضنا البعض. فلتحيا غزة, فلتحيا غزة, فلتحيا غزة, لبيك يا اقصى, لبيك يا اقصى, لبيك يا اقصى, بالروح بالدم نفديك يا اقصى, بالروح بالدم نفديك يا اقصى, بالروح بالدم نفديك يا اقصى, نفديك بمالنا, نفديك باولادنا, نفديك بانفسنا يا اقصى, والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله.
ان شاء الله ان شاء الله لذيذ ان شاء الله. For a peaceful protest
to remember Allah, Allah is always with the patient. And even though they have weapons, they have deen, and you can't beat a nation that has deen. They're fighting, they've been fighting for years with rocks and haven't been beaten. The strongest army in the world could have taken them down. They fought with rocks, why? Because they got deep.
What about
you got a heart, you take on a lion.
Absolutely. What about like 56 Islamic countries? Have a weapon, you have oil, you have gold, you have money.
Yeah, but all dogs. They only care about money and all allies of the
Turkey's
US.
Turkey's coming.
Pakistan's coming too. Turkey's Prime Minister of Pakistan.
Yeah. Turkey,
brother, they all say they're coming. This happens every year. They don't go nowhere.
What do you think they should do, like all these Muslim leaders?
All the Muslims should be unite, inshallah.
Not to fight with each other like Shia, Sunni. Okay, now last... MashaAllah. Yeah, what's your message to the Arab nations, like leaders of Arabs? Like Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar, Jordan?
On the Day of Judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you, what did you do for these people? And they're going to be held accountable for not doing anything.
My big grandparents are from Lebanon, brother.
Lebanon. What's your message to the rest of the young people around the world, those who will be watching you? What should they do?
The rest of the young people around the world, the young have always been the ones that have, you know, carried the generations. They're the flame that ignites change. So all the young people around the world, it is good if that you are the ones that raise your voices, you are the ones that carry the message that people need to hear, because only in the young people is their strength, only in the young people is their change.
The fundamental problem is one of human rights. Palestinians are denied, occupied Palestinians are denied all human rights, as set out in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And the lucky Israeli-Palestinians are subject to over 60 race-based laws. These are Nazi-style laws. It is an absolute outrage and a blot on humanity and a blot on Australia, which is second only to the United States as a supporter of apartheid Israel.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of different religions here, Sikhs here, Christians here, Jewish here. So it's not a religious issue, I think.
No, it is a fundamental human rights issue, a humanitarian issue.
It's got nothing to do with religion or anything, but it's just a humanitarian problem.
It is obfuscated by Christian Zionist Morrison as a religious issue and by the coalition and by a large part of Labor. It is not a religious issue. It's about the rights of indigenous people to live in their own country and to have full and equal human rights with everyone in humanity.
And why the world is not taking notice for that?
It's not taking notice because Western mainstream media are Zionist dominated. And America dominates the world, and America since 1967 has been a totally pro-Zionist. And that affects global perception of reality.
You're a very honest man. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure.
Let's go. You spoke very well, mashallah. You're from Palestine, I assume, yeah? So why are we here today?
We're here today because Palestinians in Gaza and in Jerusalem are being continuously targeted by the Zionist project. And there's continuous dispossession and Nakba and ethnic cleansing in Palestine.
Analysts from Pakistan, people in Pakistan, they have their heart and minds and love for Palestinian people. I can tell you honestly on my Facebook, millions of messages around the world for Palestine people. Do you want to say anything to them?
I want to say thank you from the bottom of our hearts to our brothers and sisters in Pakistan. Your solidarity means a lot and your support matters and does change and does have an impact on the Palestinian morale. So thank you. We really appreciate all of your support.
Because I love Palestine, I fight for justice, and I think we should boycott Israel and let Palestine be free, because it's Palestinian land and it always will be. It doesn't matter what anyone else says. And I wish and I hope for a free Palestine.
Do you think the world will notice us that we are here for Palestine?
I do really hope that the world will wake up, because it is very important. It cannot go on like that. It is a genocide.
I have a Turkish community here as well, those who are presenting. This is a large crowd here. Turkish Prime Minister, President, sorry, Tayyip Recep Erdogan, he's really spoke like a strongly for the Muslims on behalf of Turkish people. How do you see his stance? Very brave.
He is very brave, and he's one of the only Muslim leaders that are speaking about, and it makes us proud to be Turkish.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes, yes.
People in Pakistan, they're looking at like Turkish president as a savior now, because he's the only one in 55 countries who spoke very loud and clear. How do you see that as Turkish?
Well, we obviously appreciate it that at least someone is brave enough to come up and speak up. And I think we need more people to come up and speak up, but also to condemn and actually take some strong actions. So we're expecting the rest from the rest of the world as well, not just the Muslim part of the world, but everybody to finally recognize what's happening in Palestine and condemn it strongly.
These are the 8 days, like, you know, everyone's celebrating, everyone, but we're here for injustice, not with your family, cooking, cleaning, doing other things. How do you feel that? Does it break your heart?
Well, it does break my heart, and I feel like our privilege needs to be put to good use. So I guess it's a very tiny, not even a sacrifice to make, to just be here to show our solidarity.
People, those who don't know this dispute very well, the conflict, or people in Pakistan, do you have any message for them?
I think as a Muslim community, we all need to stand up together and unite, because if we don't, if we're divided, then what do we expect from the rest of the world?
Inshallah. So the message from Turkish community is stand up and unite together for this injustice.
We today speak truth to power. We today stand not powerless anymore, but loud, proud and powerful in solidarity together.